Welcome back to my channel. It's your girl Mooti. You're watching XOXO Mooti.
Woo! I feel like we have to cheer. We can't just leave the quiet.
Okay.
Yeah.
And today's video is going to be about being black and Muslim in America, in school, at work, anywhere. So y'all already know these two people, Fatima and Firdaus, because y'all should have seen us in our other video. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. We're gonna go ahead and jump right into the video. Basically, what we're gonna be doing today is I'm gonna be asking them four questions, and it's just gonna lead on to a discussion just to kind of have an idea as to how we feel being black and Muslim in different communities. Starting off with the first one. So ladies, what has your experience been being black and Muslim, like at school, for example?
Okay, so I can go first if y'all don't mind. So for me, I'm not the only black Muslim in my school, or the black Muslim woman or hijabi in my school. There are quite a few, and there have been like quite a few before me, and you know. So I feel like I'm not personally like that much of an outsider. I'm not like that, like an alien or anything, but I still do feel like, you know, kind of
a challenge.
Yeah, it still is a challenge, because I mean, I am kind of different. Like, out of like what, 40 plus thousand students, there's like 10 of us. No, not even 10, like 5 black Muslim hijabi women. But in Muslim, black Muslim general, is probably a good 25, 30 of us. But like, yeah, so that's what my experience has been. But personally, this is just me. I don't know, I find it like harder to be a part of the black community than the Muslim community. Mm-hmm. I feel like that's just my school, only because I relate more to Muslims, and it's just easier to be like do things with Muslims, yeah, than people that you relate to. Whereas like black people, even though I relate to black people because I'm obviously black, you know, I just feel like our interests, some interests don't really align. Like, for example, black people drink, or everyone drinks that's not Muslim, but like black people drink a lot, or like they party a lot, which is completely fine, like perfectly fine, but that's not something I'm into. So I just find myself like not really like in that community that much. Even though I would love to be, like, I really, really wish that I had more just black friends. There's never the setting for me to do that, I feel like. But yeah, that's just me.
All right, what's your experience being?
Like, two different experiences, because I transferred schools. My old school that I used to go to, I tried to be really involved in like our MSA and stuff, but I felt like the people there weren't as receiving of me, probably because I was black, and no one really, like my first year I had some black friends that I grew up with, so it was easy. But after they all left and I was kind of the only one there, and we were all like, our schedules didn't align anymore, I kind of felt alone. So most of my friends that are not, if I have friends that are not Muslim, they're black. Cause I don't really, it's hard for me to really, relate to people that are not black unless they're Muslim, for me personally. But right now in my school, I have a lot of friends that are Muslims, and they're none of them are like hijabis, but they're all like Muslim, and we kind of get along and everything. But I have one particular girl in my class who's black, and I feel like I relate with her even more, even though she's not Muslim at all. And we don't have anything like religion in common, but we talk religion a lot. But I just feel like it's easier a little bit for me to be friends with her, to associate with her, just because of that commonality, because there's some struggles that we both have. But I'm not saying I don't like right now in my school, I feel like everyone is super like nice, and no one is like racist or anything, as I felt more in my old school. But it's just still easier to relate to people who are black. But I feel like it just depends on the setting and what we're doing and what we're talking about. But I feel like I relate with both really well.
Yeah.
But if it was to choose between the two, I can't really choose because they're both different. But I would say I have a good mix of both, to be honest. That's what I would say.
That's good. I wish, oh my gosh, that I had like a good mix. Like, I really, really wish.
As far as me, my story is completely different. even though I am the only black Muslim hijabi at my school, I was the only one for 2 years. I just met another girl that was a black Muslim hijabi last semester, so I've only known her for like 4 months. It was completely different. I felt like I saw it as an opportunity for me to get out of my comfort zone, the only reason why I decided to get out of my comfort zone is that so people can know me. So that people can know that there's a black Muslim at this school. So that people can connect with me and talk to me so they can get more information as to how black Muslims really are. Because people really feel like we can't do anything. We have to wear, you know, burqa from head to toe. People ask me the most ridiculous questions ever.
I thought only white people were Muslim or Arabs. You speak Islam, you speak Muslim.
Like, I've got that so many times. Like,
exactly. So I feel like I kind of set that platform out at my school. So now people at school already know me. The moment they see me, they already know this is how she rocks, this is how she's not. And I really feel like my personality takes a big toll on that. I have friends that are black and I have friends that aren't black. As far as in my MSA at my school, when I went to the MSA meeting, I felt like I didn't fit in. Even though I was in a room full of Muslim people, I was still the only black person and I still felt like I didn't fit in. I just felt like I wasn't welcomed enough into the community as they should have welcomed me. You know, being the only black Muslim and this is me trying to come join your organization, you should have welcomed me more. Mm-hmm. I sat by myself. I wasn't offered any snacks. Because you know how they give you refreshments?
Yeah.
They didn't offer me
that. That's rude. Actually, that's kind of rude.
Because everybody knew each other, but I was like new. So I felt like they should have welcomed me. So that reason is why I was not involved in my MSA. However, when the new black Muslim sister came on campus, I told her, go join the MSA. You go for yourself, go to the meeting, maybe you'll have a different experience. But me, that's not the kind of community I grew up in. In the community I grew up in, we all talk to each other. Either I know you or I don't, I'm still gonna speak to you. Mm-hmm. So I just felt like that kind of rubbed me off the wrong way. But I'll always support my MSA and I'll always support other MSAs, black, Muslim or not.
Exactly, and like kind of the same thing for me. So I grew up more around, Nigerian Muslims, like we are all really close, right, in our community here. But I also grew up really tight with a lot of the non-black Muslims. So like I knew a lot of Arabs, I knew a lot of Pakistanis. I got to my school and it was that same demographic of people. It's the same Arabs, Pakistanis, or whatever, wherever, right? I was pretty comfortable with them because I grew up like that and I already knew them on top of that. So I was welcomed easily because I already knew them. But I know for a fact that other black Muslims that came to our school that didn't know them or didn't grow up with them did feel excluded, and I always made it my thing where all my friends know exactly where I stand with inclusion, with making people feel welcome, with having programs that are like meant for everyone, not just like programs that like brown people and like Arabs will understand. Even though they are the majority, but they're still not they're not everyone, you know?
Like, I feel so grateful because I don't have this, I can't say the same thing she's saying. Mm-hmm. My friends understand me. They never make me feel uncomfortable. It can be any event going on, they're gonna always make sure I'm comfortable. They're gonna always make sure I have that space in order to practice my religion. Mm-hmm. My supervisor, I simply told her, I just need to be praying while I'm on the clock. I don't mind using my lunch break, and she provided me a whole office so I can pray in. Normal people, it's just gonna be like, find you a spot to go pray, or they never offer you. Like, I really can't relate with y'all, but I understand what y'all saying because I really just really appreciate my friends. They all make me feel comfortable. When it's time to any event, they give me like, you know, the little sparkling cider and everything, so.
I mean, I'm the same way, kind of like Muti, because even at my job, my manager, even when I don't pray, like days that I'm like off and I don't have to pray, she'll be like, girl, aren't you gonna go pray? And I'm like, oh, like technically I don't have to pray now. And then like I explain why like I don't have to pray. And in school, like, I mean, because my school, I don't really kind of hang out with those people a lot because they do drink a lot, so I don't like to be around that kind of thing. And anytime they're like taking a break or like studying or something, it's gonna be like at the club or something.
Yeah.
And I'm obviously not gonna go to the club, but like when it is, because there are multiple Muslims in my class, I'm not the only Muslim, I'm not gonna say I'm the only Muslim. People, they do, like my class as a whole, they take their time to try to include us. Like I remember there's like things during Ramadan, like they'd like do for us and like they try to plan things around it. I remember now we were, well, school's canceled now because of the corona. They were supposed to have like a whole, like dinner thing at the end of the semester, but then they were gonna push it up because Ramadan is gonna be at the end of the semester.
Oh, that's so sweet.
So like they try to like include us a lot and I really appreciate that. But I feel like that's just, if you're around non-Muslims, you have to be the kind of person who's gonna show them who you are from the beginning.
Yes. Exactly.
You can't be someone who like you're being a bit wishy-washy about your because if in the beginning you're drinking with them, if you kinda try to stop, they're gonna be like, why are you trying to stop? You were doing it before, you know, kind of thing. Mm-hmm. I mean, yes, you can make the whole like, oh, I'm trying to become a better Muslim and stuff. But if they respect you more when they see you doing it from day one. Mm-hmm. And from day one, if they see that this is something you don't tolerate, they'll never try to like put it on you. And that's one thing I had to learn. I mean, that's one thing I learned and I really appreciate too that Muti was talking
about. That's something I've always been practicing. It can be the smallest thing. My hair can be short and literally my friend will come and try to fix my scar. I'm like, that's how it's supposed to be. But it's literally the smallest thing. My friend, I just came from vacation and she was like, oh, what time are you going to get up to pray? I'm like, oh, girl, she said, okay, wake me up so I can pray too. Even though she's a different religion, wake me up so I can pray too. Y'all see, it's just the smallest thing. You have to let them know and just set it straight from the beginning. Thank y'all so much for watching. I know we only discussed one topic, but it really just got real deep and it got in. If y'all want us to continue doing more videos like this, and if you have any questions or any topics you want us to talk about, go ahead and drop it in the description below. We have been hijabis basically our whole lives, literally had ups and downs and things like that, and we're just growing from here on. So y'all don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, and I'll see y'all in the next video. You already know it's on and popping.